In this video, we'll dive deep into ASP.NET Core Middleware, exploring inline middleware, conventional middleware, short-circuiting middleware, conditional execution with UseWhen and MapWhen, and even rate-limiting middleware with a hands-on demo. By the end of this tutorial, you'll have a clear understanding of how middleware processes requests and how you can customize it for your applications. So, let's get started. Before starting, let me show you what we have in this demo web API project. Here, we have two controllers, customer controller and product controller, where I've implemented the CRUD functionalities. We also have the entity classes and the repositories managing the database operations. The project source code is available for our exclusive Patreon supporters. If you're not a member yet, you can join the community and access exclusive benefits using the link provided in the description. Now, let's take a look at a simple middleware example. Here, we are using the app.Use method to register an inline middleware. This middleware takes two parameters, context, which represents the current HTTP request, and next, which is a delegate that passes control to the next middleware in the pipeline. Inside the middleware, we log the incoming request by printing the request path to the console. Then, we invoke await next, which hands over control to the next middleware in line. Once the response is processed and comes back, we log the response status code before the middleware completes execution. Let's run the application and try to invoke an API method using Postman. You can see the request log first. Then, the execution happens, and finally, the response log is written. Let's try another API method. We can see the logs in the same way. You might have noticed that the path in the request log is now different. Now, let's add a second middleware to better understand the flow of request processing. This new middleware follows the same pattern as the first one. Let's run the application and invoke an API method. When a request comes in, it first hits middleware 1, which logs the request and passes it to middleware 2. Middleware 2 then logs the request and continues the pipeline. If there are no further middlewares, the request reaches the endpoint. Once the response is generated, the execution unwinds in reverse order. Middleware 2 processes the response first. Then middleware 1 executes its response logic. Now, let's see a more structured approach by creating a conventional middleware class. I'm creating a new class called Logging Middleware. This class takes a request delegate parameter named next, which represents the next middleware in the pipeline. The code logic resides in the invocasing method, which takes an HTTP context as input. As before, this middleware also logs the request path, passes control to the next middleware, and then logs the response status code before finishing execution. To register this middleware in our pipeline, we use app.useMiddleware method. Now, while invoking an API method, you can see that we are receiving logs from the new middleware as well. Next, let's talk about short-circuiting middleware, a middleware that can stop the request pipeline and prevent further execution when certain conditions are met. To demonstrate this, I'm adding a value named access token inside app settings. This will act as a required authentication token for incoming requests. Next, let's create a middleware class. We'll include a configuration dependency to fetch the access token from app settings. This middleware checks if the request contains an access token header. If the header exists and matches the value from the configuration, it allows the request to continue by calling await next. Otherwise, it short-circuits the pipeline by returning a 400 bad request response with the message invalid token. Finally, we register this middleware in program class. Now, while invoking an API method, you can see that we are receiving a 400 bad request response. For any API method, we'll receive the same response. Now, let's add the access token header and try the request again. And this time, we got a successful response. So far, we've seen how middleware runs for every request in the pipeline. But what if we need a middleware to execute only for specific routes? That's where app.Use/when comes in. It allows us to conditionally apply middleware based on the request. Here, I've modified our access token middleware to run only for requests starting with /API/customer. Now, let's try to invoke one of the customer API methods without an access token. As expected, we receive a 400 bad request response. But with the correct access token, the request goes through successfully. However, for the product API, we receive a successful response even without an access token, since the middleware is not applied to that route. Now, what if we want to create separate branches for different request paths? This is where app.map comes in. It allows us to define branching middleware, meaning a specific middleware or logic will only execute when the request matches a particular route. For example, when a request comes to /API/getDateTime, it executes the provided logic. In this case, we return a JSON response containing the current date and time. This approach is commonly used in minimal APIs, which provide a lightweight way to define API endpoints without controllers. We'll be covering minimal APIs in more detail in an upcoming video. Now, let's try to invoke the method we created using Postman. As you can see, we are receiving the JSON response. Next, let's take a look at app.mapWhen, another useful method for branching the request pipeline based on a condition. Unlike app.map, which maps directly to a specific route, app.mapWhen gives us more flexibility by allowing us to apply conditional logic for routing requests. In this example, we're checking if the request path starts with /API/date. If it does, the request is routed to a specific handler defined inside the app.mapWhen block. Inside this block, we use app.run to define the logic that should be executed for this branch. In this case, we return a JSON response with the current date and time along with a custom message. Now, let's test this. We've received the response with the custom message. Since the branching is based on a condition, we can receive the same response for any URLs that start with /API/date. To help you understand these concepts more clearly, I've created a demo rate limiting middleware. You can check out the source code, which is available on Patreon, to explore and understand the implementation in detail. Now, let me show you how it works. This middleware allows a maximum of 2 requests from an IP in every 5 seconds. Once the limit is reached, we receive a too many requests response. If you want to explore the source code, join our Patreon community for in-depth clarity. Also, check out our .NET Core Web API playlist for more related content. The link is available in the description. If you found this video helpful, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. See you all in the next video. Thank you.